to live, I love God. To die young, I love God. To be in good health, I love God. To be always suffering, I love God. To go out of India, I love God. To return to France, I love God. To be a preacher, I love God. To be a novice, master, I love God. God and His adorable will. What else matters? Jesus, my master, nay, my brother, grant that I may always be your apostle, and that always and everywhere I may love you. This meditation by Reverend Henry Fortunatus Como, dated September 10, 1895, is a solemn promise and a total surrender to the will of God. We, the Sophian family, feel highly privileged to express in joy and esteem our love and gratitude towards our most beloved founder, Reverend Henry Fortunatus Como.
He was born in Tours, France, on 10th December 1871 to Monsieur Salvin Como and Madame Pauline Como. His mother was an extremely religious person who encouraged all her children to commit their lives to God. He was gifted with a great intelligence, a dynamic personality, and infused with a powerful experience of God's life. He made his solemn profession in September 10, 1893 and was ordained a priest on December 19, 1896. After his ordination, he was given permission to prepare himself to leave for Rajputana mission in India.
In 1913, he was appointed as the Bishop of Ajmer, gifted with a keen foresight and reading the signs of times. Father Founder's heart was deeply moved with compassion towards the local people, especially girls and women. He felt the need to promote education, which alone could eradicate their deplorable conditions. With the blessings of Pope Pius X, he founded the Congregation of Mission Sisters of Ajmer on 26th April 1911. The first Sophia school started in 1919. His sister Josephine, fondly remembered as Mother Mary Matilda, became its first principal. The word Sophia in Greek means wisdom. The institution's motto, Arbha Buddhidai, means giving wisdom to little ones, focuses on Bishop Como's visionary approach to education.
Brethren, I pray you, learn to believe that God has a blessing for this country. God is a spirit of love. He is brooding over this land of India and is brooding over this Rajputana mission and every sphere of work within it. And He is willing to bless. Pray today, then all of you, the workers whom God calls to His own service in the mission. Pray that everyone called may hear the voice and obey it. Pray that everyone concerned may, by the grace of God, find it in their hearts to make the necessary sacrifice. I ask you to trust His almighty power. Trust Him every day. I wish I could tell you rightly what I see, at least a glimpse of it, And that is that the whole of your life, every day, has to be the work of God Himself. Tell Him, "Here I am, I yield to Thy power and to Thy love." Ah, believe me, He will then work wonders with you. God never works anything but wonders. That's His nature. Take the simplest of things, a blade of grass, a little worm, or a flower. What wonders! And will not God work wonders in your hearts? He will. He is willing to mold you as really as a potter molds his clay. He will do it. He is waiting to do for you more than you can even conceive. Every yearning of your heart, every blessing which you wish to have had, every prayer that you have sent up, oh, just believe that God is there to work it all in you, in every difficulty, in every circumstance. God is there to work it in you. Dearest children, may your Blessed Lady help you make a perfect consecration for the furtherance of the Christ's kingdom. Be honest, be earnest, be simple, be childlike and say, "Lord, everything I have, I offer it to Thee. Anything I can do for Thy glory, Lord, here I am. I give myself up to Thee."
The obedient disciple asks no question about possibilities or results. He accepts every order in the confidence that his teacher has provided for all that is needed.
Love does not reason or reckon, but leaps up to follow the beloved blindfolded. Wheresoever he goes, whether to prison and to death or to victory and life.
Our only strength is in keeping every minute in contact with God. Every minute allowing God to work in ourselves. This is what we must understand and prove and testify to the world.
My dear children, the one great need of mankind, the very thing which Christ came to accomplish, is to restore love and charity in this world. When man sinned, why was it that he sinned? Selfishness triumphed. He sought self instead of God.
Indeed, if Christ comes into you as your life, it must not be something hidden in your heart, but something that proves itself in every action and in every moment of your existence.
Thank you.
Archive is the place where we keep Father Founder's handwritten letters, spiritual exhortations, and his few personal belongings. Cathedral Church is the main church in Ajmer, where our revered Father Founder's mortal remains were laid to rest before the altar of the most sacred heart of Jesus. Mother House is the main house of our Institute of Mission Sisters of Ajmer. The institute bifurcated into two provinces on 14th March 2001. They are called as St. Francis Provincial House in Ajmer and St. Clair's Provincial House in Mumbai. Sophia School was the first educational institution founded by our Father Founder on 16th May 1919 as a concern to educate the daughters of Rajasthan. Sophia College was started in 1959 with a hostel facility to provide higher education to girls. Now, Sophia College is one of the finest autonomous college of its kind in India. The Sofian family feels privileged to express its joy and gratitude towards its beloved father as we pay tribute to him for his loving service towards the humanity.
Beloved Father, Right Reverend Bishop Henry Como, your love for Jesus led you to this foreign land of ours to offer your life as a sacrifice for the redemption of God's children here. This burning love and desire of your heart was seen and experienced by those who lived with you. God, our Heavenly Father, we praise and thank you for the gift of our beloved Father Founder, Bishop Henry Como, and all the blessings we have received through him on our school. Heavenly Father, if it is your will, raise Right Reverend Bishop Henry Como to the ranks of saints so that his example may draw us always in accordance with your will. We ask this in the name of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
There came a young magician from the lush greens of France to the fiery desert of Rajasthan. With confidence, he called the magical words,
"My God and my all,"
and nurtured a city fortified with Aravallis.
Sofia,
he ordered,
bloom as a beauteous rose.
And behold, vanished people's woes. Sofia gleamed at its zenith in the virgin forest. Gallant he walked with the magic wand of justice, faith and truth, to educate the poor and the youth, to uplift women and to stand against their demons. Upteen noble souls followed his preach to heal and to teach. Today, with the Father he stands and looks afar. How the fragrance has spread. Knowledge has become power. He smiles and says,
"My God and my all."